Hello, I'm Darren Crapo, and welcome to the Thursday, well, almost Friday edition of UFO Planet. On today's program, we'll be visiting France, the United States of America, the United Kingdom, and later in the program, we'll be joined by Janine Murray, the UFO Planet correspondent from Australia, who will help us examine a couple of fantastic videos from Australia. All of that's going to get started right away, but first check out some of the clips that you'll see on today's show. Some very fascinating clips to show you today, and some of them are, well, they're unforgettable. But first, we're going to head down to Babylon, New York, and this is for a light crossing up in the sky, shot recently on September 2nd. This particular video was sent in to MUFON, and the person who was shooting the video was uncertain of what they were shooting. Shot with a cell phone, not a bad job for shooting with a cell phone. I know there are some that will say this is potentially the ISS. It certainly has a very similar signature to it. So as you can see there, the particular person who shot this video was a repairman for the Marine Corps for 8 years and is very familiar with what aircraft look like. Now I suspect that when someone with those credentials sees something up in the sky that they think is fairly fascinating, we should all stand up and pay attention. Definitely something crossing the sky there in Babylon, New York, in the United States of America on September 2nd. Very interesting video. Not sure what he was looking at, but like I say, if a person has their credentials where they've been working on radar, that they definitely got to know what an airplane looks like. Or either that or the people using that radar may be in trouble. Next, we're going to move to Brighton, Ontario, here in Canada. And this is an interesting video. It's more lights in the sky, but this time these lights are blue. I have never seen anything like this. Check this out. Not a particularly wonderful video here as far as being able to see the object in the black there, but we're going to do some zoom-ins and cutouts here to make it easier. I want to thank Tectonic Cat, a great follower of UFO Planet, for participating and sending me his video. Now, in the digital zoom motion stop there, you can see these lights are blue. We normally don't see blue lights, so that pretty much rules out that they're Chinese lanterns going up in a pattern there, because Chinese lanterns would give off an orange, fiery type glow that we're all familiar with by now. So what do you think Tectonic Cat was looking at over Brighton, Ontario, Canada? As I mentioned before, the thing that really fascinated me about this video was the color of the lights. I've seen the shape, the, you know, lights in the sky. A lot of the videos that we look at are lights in a dark sky. I believe there are actually three lights there, but you can only kind of see two of them fairly decent. Don't you think that's fascinating? Now, we've seen the ruby reds, we've seen the orange glow, and now we've seen a blue UFO. Absolutely fascinating. Thanks so much for participating and sending that into the program, Tectonic Cat. Appreciate that. Now we're going to take a look at an object in the sky behind the trees in Monaco, France. And I can promise you, this is the type of UFO video that a lot of people like to see. This particular video was shot on April 20th. Let's check it out here. Now you're going to have to look close here. I run through the video several times here because it goes very fast. So now look at the bottom of your screen there where the arrow is, you see it, and this is in ultra slow motion, so you can have a really good look at what our researcher Gavin Fry tracked down on the internet. Celeste there keeping an eye on everyone there, scanning you to see what you're up to. Hopefully she's not a double agent working for the NSA. As far as I know, she's fully dedicated to UFO Planet. But take a look, you guys. Here's a good view of this object up in the sky here in very ultra slow motion, frame by frame. And now let's zoom in there and have a really good look. Almost looks like a penguin, doesn't it? Do a little enhancement on the digital zoom there. And just another quick run through of the video in slow motion so you can have another idea of, or another view of what it looked like. Interesting, filmed over Monaco, France. I'd really like to know what your opinion is on that video. I'm not sure if it's real, I'm not sure if it's fake. And you know, you see so many videos that are shot that are grainy, that are shot in the dark, that when you see something like that, it captures your attention immediately, making you wonder if it's real, simply because it's almost too clear to believe. And it's sad that it is that way. I just want to say thanks to everyone for participating in finding Celeste last week on the train, on the locomotive, and for everyone who posted comments. And here's the comments that you had posted on episode 57 of UFO Planet. And once again, I just want to say thanks to everyone who participated and found Celeste. She was hidden pretty good there, so you had to have a good eye. That means you're really paying attention. I also just want to send a very special shout out to our French-Canadian viewers. For those of you who don't know, Canada is bilingual. We have two official languages in Canada. Primarily those in the East speak French, and those of us here in the West speak English. So I just wanted to say bonjour to all the French-speaking individuals who watch the program, and you just about heard the extent of my French. Well, that and, you know, some really important phrases like ouvrez la porte, which I believe is close the door, and arrête, which is stop. And if it's not on the cereal box, I pretty much don't know it. Here in Canada, half the cereal box is in English and half is in French. So if you don't get the opportunity to take French classes in school, that's the extent of your training. So anyway, thanks so much to all of you in Eastern Canada, primarily the French-speaking community, who watch UFO Planet on a regular basis. Very much appreciated. Now, let's get moving on here. We're going to go to Phoenix, New York next. Had no idea there was such a place, but I learned that this week. And this was a video that was sent in to me at 4u2ctv.com. Now, it's a couple of years old, shot in 2010, but it's an interesting video of a family UFO encounter in Phoenix, New York. Here we go. Now in this digital slow motion, you can see there's supposedly some objects around that, like three or four craft around this bright object in the sky. What do you make of this digital zoom still photo cut from this video, folks? Shot in Phoenix, New York. I'd like to thank Mike Middleton for participating in UFO Planet and sending us that video for today's program. Next, we're going to head over to the United Kingdom. Now, I'm going to attempt to pronounce the name. Forgive me if I get it wrong. Shropshire in the United Kingdom. And this is something up in the sky. I don't know if it's birds. I don't know if it's a UFO, but it's really fascinating to look at. So let's take a look. This was sent to us by Starman. Appreciate that very much. Stellar Starman 1 on YouTube. Shot on July 28, 2013. There's the original clip, and you see things just moving extremely fast. Now, Stellar Starman, he slows this down. This is his editing here, slowing these objects down so you can have a look at them. Now, I want you to pay attention when the objects disappear by the UFO Planet logo there. Did you notice that it almost looks like a bird that spreads its wings? Is there a potential of that, or is this an unidentified flying object of extraterrestrial origin? This entire program is made up of unidentified flying objects as opposed to unidentified flying saucers. If it's up in the sky and it's flying and you can't identify it, it's a UFO. Now, I just want to mention that because sometimes I get emails from people who are really confused as to what the objectives of UFO Planet is. UFO Planet's objective is to show the world the videos that are captured by people around the world that they are unable to identify, which gives them the qualifications for an unidentified flying object. As opposed to a lot of people who confuse that with unidentified flying saucers or extraterrestrial objects. This is a study of all objects that we can't identify. And that's exactly what the term means. So it's really a lot of fun to participate with everyone and have everyone give their comments as to what they think we're looking at. Next, we're going to take a look at a ball of light up in the sky over Yorba Linda, California. This was also sent into UFO Planet, shot in December 2011. But you can tell that the person who is shooting it is very genuine and very excited about the experience that he's having. Check this out.
It is. All right, got it on my camera. All right. I'll be talking to the camera as I'm talking to you, Alex. I got this ball of light right now on my camera. It's flying directly over my house. It's not a, it ain't a plane, it ain't a jet, you'd hear it right now. It's bright and some weird ass shit just flew over my pad and I can't tell you what it was. As you could tell, my voice, I'm breathing hard. This thing's right over my house. It's moving. Breathe. All right, Alex.
Caleb, I don't see shit. I
want to
see.
It's right over my house, man. Say something, Alex. Say hello to the camera.
Hello.
Again.
Hello.
That's my friend Alex. I'm on the phone with him right now. There's a thing flying over my pad. I'm watching it as it goes by. Still silent, can't hear shit.
You know, looking right over your direction, right into the pool in the backyard. Scared you away.
All right, now it dimmed out. I can't see it on the camera, but I can still see it with my eyes. I can't see it with the camera. Oh shit. It's gone. It's gone. Hear that, everybody? It's gone. That's the end of the video.
Well, let's all help Gabriel out there. What do you think he was looking at? You could tell he was very excited having a conversation with one of his friends on his cell phone while he viewed that. I thought that was very exciting. And it's very nice that Gabriel spoke while he was recording that. It makes a huge difference. Well, you've all heard the term Blame It on Canada, made famous by a popular cartoon on television. Well, our next segment, which is News from Space, well, you can probably blame this one on Canada and be perfectly legitimate. Let's get this video started here. And I can tell already that the studio's having some issues producing fluid video tonight. Hopefully you'll bear with me on that. Now, this is Canada. That's what my backyard looks like. Well, maybe a couple of hundred miles away from my backyard, but there used to be huge saber-toothed tigers around here. There used to be giant sloths. And they tell us, at least scientists tell us, that there used to be giant, enormous camels. All of that changed, though, when a big catastrophic event happened 12,900 years ago and a comet struck in Canada. They're saying that killed off a lot of the large mammals that we no longer have on our planet. That's really sad. But it certainly produced a beautiful country. Now, this is a comet that's already gone by Earth, but coming up very soon, we're going to be taking a look at the comet that is going to be passing by Earth sometime, they say, around November, I believe. And hopefully this one won't hit Canada and they won't have anything to blame on us up here in the white north. Now it's time to head off for our interview down under in Australia. And I was joined earlier today by Janine Murray. And Janine is going to share with us a couple of her own personal UFO experiences. Plus, she's going to help analyze a couple of videos that we have here from Australia. Janine herself has been involved in several UFO research groups down in Australia and has now joined the UFO Planet family as our official UFO Planet correspondent from Australia. Let's see what Janine and I had to say earlier today. Hello, Janine. Welcome to the program. Thank you for joining us on UFO Planet.
Thank you very much, Darren. It's lovely to be here.
Well, Janine, it's nice to hear a voice from down under, and I'm sure you have some excellent experiences to share with us today. And I know you have one in particular. What is your story there?
Yes, well, on Monday night, which was the 2nd of September, I actually went out between 7 and 8 p.m. to close my garage door, and there was a really, really bright light up in the night sky, which was unusual because I sort of know where a lot of the stars are positioned, and this was something new to me. And I actually stood out there for quite some minutes and was actually just, you know, standing there looking at it. And all of a sudden it just sort of went brighter, and then the light just diminished. It just disappeared. There was nothing there. There was no aircraft sound. I thought perhaps it may have been a helicopter, but there was just absolutely no sound. It was dead quiet outside.
Was there any flashing lights on the object at all, or was it a steady light?
No flashing lights. It was just stationary, but this huge bright light, it was just amazing. I haven't seen something like that for probably a couple of years. But I just couldn't believe there was just no sound. But the thing is, there was just nothing there. It just disappeared. So there was nothing that flew over. It was just, really, really odd.
Yeah, that does sound weird. Now, so you say it just disappeared. It just pretty much just vanished. So it didn't
It just
move. It was
vanished.
stationary and then it just vanished.
Yes, it just this huge bright light. I thought it might have been a police helicopter spotlight or something like that, but it was nothing I've ever seen before.
And
I
that was
just
there in Melbourne, right?
yes, in Melbourne on the Mornington Peninsula.
Okay.
It
Now
was actually
that
facing south.
and you haven't seen anything like that since then, Janine.
No, I haven't. But I did a couple of years ago experience something when I was travelling back home when I was in Mornington, which is on the other side of the Mornington Peninsula to where I used to live. It's about a 15-kilometre drive. I left Mornington to come back home, and as I was driving down this very, very quiet road, I just saw this brightest object in the sky. It was about 10:30 at night, and I was just sort of following it as I was heading home because it was straight ahead of me, and it's like it wasn't even moving. So by the time I got home and pulled up in my driveway, I got out my car, and I just stood there and was just watching this craft come over, and it was deadly quiet, but once again had a very, very bright light on it. But no sound whatsoever. It was big, it was dark, you could tell it was a dark color, and it turned on an angle to head over towards Melbourne. And as it
Okay.
turned on an angle, there was these huge red things on the back of it. They were massive, and it reminded me of a jet, a jet fighter. They have the on the back there. But this, if it was a jet, it would make noise or something. This had absolutely no noise, and it was just cruising by. It was just phenomenal. And I do remember that night there were some other sightings as well.
So you weren't the only one who saw the object then, perhaps.
Yes. Although there were a couple of other people that I discovered, just on the internet that had seen something that night. Of a similar description, but it just blew me away. So, to be honest, I'm not really sure what I saw. We do have a RAF base in Sale, which is about 3 hours away from here. So whether it is something military, I'm really not sure, but it was deadly quiet. Whatever it is, it's
Okay.
very, very fascinating.
Well, you're not the only one that's seen things there in Melbourne. We have a video here from Lou20764 on YouTube for all those that would like to go to his channel. And this is of an object that he says is aircraft carrier size. And he also films the ISS includes that in his video so that you can do a comparison. I know that you've reviewed that video, and I asked you today to help me review a couple of Australian videos. I know that in the past you have been a member of UFO organizations down in Australia. Now you're working independently, but I would really
Yes.
like to know what you think about Lou's video.
Oh, look, this recent video from Lou is absolutely fantastic. I mean, Lou's been filming our skies for about 5 years, apparently. And I've actually personally been watching Lou's footage on YouTube for about 2 years now. And this one blew me away. It was fantastic. So, I mean, according to Lou, the object was travelling a third of the speed of the ISS. The ISS usually take 90 minutes to orbit our planet, travelling at over 27,000 kilometres an hour. But this object was filmed 20 minutes after the ISS had already passed over. So that is what I find really fascinating.
Indeed.
Yes,
And
yeah.
he also has a couple of different views there of it as well. He has one with a regular camera, and then he follows that up with a scope, a night scope vision or a night vision camera view, which makes it even more interesting.
Oh, look, and when he zoomed in, Darren, you could see that the objects, it's triangular in shape.
Okay.
And there's been a lot of comments that he's just filming the ISS, but we've already seen what the ISS looks like first up. And then you see this object, and it's very, very interesting. And actually, you can see there's a bright light under the belly of this craft. So whether it's emitting light or energy, not really sure, but you can definitely see it is triangular. So we have to rule out the ISS.
Well, and for sure we can rule out the ISS with the fact that Lou recorded it 20 minutes earlier and actually was
Exactly.
brilliant enough to take a
Yes.
few seconds of footage of that so he could say, I've ruled this out because it's already gone by. Excellent job there, I think.
Yes, exactly. And I mean, look, the question is, could this be the hypersonic spy plane known as Aurora? We have seen illustrations and some pictures of what Aurora looks like, which is a secret military aircraft. It does have a thing positioned under the belly of the craft. So could it be that, or could it be another type of military aircraft, or is it something from out of space? I mean, we just don't know,
Well,
but it's a
absolutely. Now, you had mentioned there earlier about military. So, is there a base close to Melbourne then?
Yes, there is. There's Point Cook, but there's also Sale RAF base, which
Okay.
is still very much in operation. So it could be quite possible that they're developing something that the public isn't aware of at the moment.
Well, that's interesting. And so, do you guys have that kind of experimentation going on down in Australia that you're aware of?
Oh, look, I believe there is, yes, very
Okay.
much so.
I think
Yes.
all of the
I mean,
Western governments probably work together on a lot of things like that. And
oh, absolutely. We're
Australia,
not.
with its location, what a perfect place, because
Yes.
it's kind of off the beaten path when it comes to the rest of the world in certain
Yes.
ways. Although it's a beautiful place,
Exactly.
I just want to add that
Thank
for all
you.
my
It's a lovely
Australian friends.
place.
Now, there's
Canada's
also a,
lovely too.
it is, yes, another video that I asked you to look at and help review on today's program was a video that was shot by UFUN Official in
Yes.
Adelaide. Very interesting video of, well, it looks like an aircraft just doing circles in the sky. What do you make of that, Janine?
Well, look, I found this video very, very interesting to watch. I found it so interesting that I actually wanted to talk to someone who knows what they're talking about. So I spoke to someone who's got 35 years aviation experience. I
Okay.
showed them the video, yes. And it is of their opinion that this is actually a jet that uses a smoker. If people don't know what a smoker is, it means that they can actually pour oil onto the hot engine exhaust when they want to make a trail
Similar
while
to
they're
what
still
they
on
would use in
the jet.
an air show, correct?
Absolutely. And a perfect example of that is the RAAF, sorry, the RAAF's roulettes. They use the same technique in their air display. So if I just think, just in my opinion, if I'm allowed to say this, that I do believe it is just someone having a bit of fun, or they're practicing for some sort of aerial display. Sometimes they can do this. They use these smokers so they can see where they've been. So if they're practicing, they can see exactly where they've been. So I hope that makes some sense. The thing is, if it is a chemtrail, I think it's done very elaborately, and perhaps a little bit too obvious for the public to see. That's just
Well,
my
I think so
opinion.
too. And the other thing I thought about that when I was looking at the video, and you see the pilot continues to travel through his trail. And I think if there was
Exactly, yeah.
chemicals in that, I don't think the pilot would be too anxious to keep breathing that air by staying inside that circle as he lays down more
Absolutely.
smoke. So perhaps there, maybe
Absolutely.
what we were looking at is exactly
Yeah.
that. Maybe someone preparing for an air show, doing some practice, checking out the
Yes.
aircraft, checking their smoker to see if it's functional. It doesn't
Exactly.
look like there was a secret objective there to lay down chemicals or something like that, in your opinion.
That's exactly right. And I mean, look, some people don't know really what chemtrails what it actually means. So the definition here is chemical or biological agents deliberately sprayed at high altitudes for geoengineering purposes unknown to the public. So my point is that if, you know, this is so, why are they doing it in such an elaborate way where everyone can see it? So, you know, I just think perhaps, in my opinion, I'd have to rule out chemtrails.
Sounds very logical to me, and I think your explanation of someone practicing or having some fun may well describe what we were looking at in that video.
Yeah, anyone who's been to an air show would see this kind of display happening, and I think that's what it could be. Yeah, a lot of people are very adamant that it's chemtrail, but just, you know, through a little bit of research myself, I just find that it is. It's just someone having a bit of fun or just practicing. Yeah.
Excellent. Well, I absolutely appreciate you taking the time to review those videos with us, to share your experience and to be on the program today, Janine. We hope
My
to have
pleasure.
You up on the program many times in the future, reviewing That's things fun. That are going on down under in Australia. Maybe check out some of the other parts of the world that are close to you there.
Yes.
There's a lot happening there, isn't there?
There certainly is. There's actually been a lot of UFO activity in Melbourne and also New South Wales on the East Coast. So, yeah, there's a lot of things happening lately. I'm not sure why, but I think because it's spring here, you know, UFO activity tends to increase a little bit more when the weather gets better, believe it or not.
Well, I agree with you. And because I live in southern Alberta, where we only have about 3.5 days of summer, that's why I don't get to see too many, I suppose. I shouldn't say 3.5 days. We have at least 45. But in any case, I look forward to speaking to you more in the future, and appreciate you being on the show today. Thank you so much, Janine.
My pleasure. Thank you very much, Darren. Thank you.
Fascinating information from the land down under. I just want to say thanks to Janine for her first appearance on UFO Planet. Look forward to many more. Appreciate your insight on what we were viewing tonight. I just also want to mention, too, I guess some of you noticed last episode that there was a UFO in my studio, an unidentified flying object, a housefly. I affectionately have called her Squish, because when I catch up to her, she's going to live up to her name, trust me. She was flying around the studio again today. I should have recorded me trying to catch her. It was probably more entertaining than the program. But in any case, that's 9 videos you saw tonight, plus heard 2 of Janine's personal experiences. I hope you enjoyed UFO Planet, and thank you very much for watching. I hope you all have a fantastic weekend, and I'll see you again on Monday.